Many years ago, Purushottama Deva ruled over the state of Orissa. He was a great devotee of Lord Jagannath. King Purushottama considered the Lord as the proprietor of everything, the ruler of the country, and himself to be a menial servant of the Lord. One time, the king went on a tour to South India. He reached a kingdom called Kanchi and wandered in the beautiful garden of the capital city. There, he chanced to meet the princess of Kanchi, Padmavati Devi, who was a very beautiful maiden. King Purushottama and Padmavati Devi instantly liked each other. O King of Kalinga, since we are in the great kingdom of Kanchi, I think it would be humble and respectful to greet the king.
Certainly, even I wanted to greet the king and the queen of Kanchi. We shall visit their palace. Make arrangements accordingly.
Yes, my majesty, we shall do it right away. The king of Puri is welcomed with great honor at the palace. The king and the queen were very happy to meet King Purushottama, including Princess Padmavati, who was already attracted to him. Being pleased by King Purushottama, they decided to offer the hand of Princess Padmavati in marriage to the king.
Well, it has been quite a long time since King Purushottama left Kanchi. I was thinking if we can put forth an official proposal of our daughter Padmavati's marriage with King Purushottama.
That is a very good idea. Certainly, my dear queen. My dear minister, take this marriage proposal to Puri and check the well-being of the king and his subject matters in his kingdom. And get back to us with the message.
Yes, my dear king, I shall leave immediately.
The minister went to Puri and was accorded a warm welcome by King Purushottama. It was the time of Rath Yatra in Puri, the king's favorite of all times, and this marriage proposal only added to his happiness.
Honorable minister, I request you to stay a few more days here and attend the Rath Yatra of Lord Jagannath, for it is the most prominent festival in Puri.
Certainly, Your Highness. I shall take it as my great fortune to experience the Kat festival and will extend my stay on your request.
Finally, it was the auspicious day of Rath Yatra. The deities of Lord Jagannath, Lord Balabhadra and Lady Subhadra, along with Sudarshan Chakra, were brought from the temple to the chariots. Thousands of people gathered to witness the event, and there was a tumultuous sound of kirtan, drums and conch shells.
Witnessing. Why is the king holding a broom in his hand and sweeping the roads? Is he a king or a sweeper? Well, we do not want our innocent princess Padmavati to get married to a sweeper. Sweeping the roads is the duty of low-class men. What kind of behavior is this? This is a great insult. I should immediately convey this to my king. Humble obeisances to the glorious majesty.
What happened? Why do you look so desperate and agitated?
Yes, my dear king. It is because I have witnessed the low-class behavior of the king of Puri.
What? What have you witnessed? Tell me everything clearly.
It was the day of Rath Yatra of their lordships. I saw the king holding a broom in his hand and sweeping the roads of Puri. O great king, How can Princess Padmavati marry a man who is a sweeper?
Immediately, send a message to Puri that I am not willing to get my princess married to King Purushottama. What is this? The king of Kanchi has withdrawn the marriage proposal based on my menial sweeping service to my dear Lord Jagannath.
My dear king! I have an urgent message for you. The king of Kanchi has arranged the Swayamvar ceremony of Princess Padmavati, for which he has invited all the kings except you.
This is not only an insult to me, but for my lordships too. Send immediately the war message to Kanchi. I will defeat the king of Kanchi and capture the princess. A war message to the king of Kanchi? I shall agree on one condition. If the king loses the battle, he must surrender his deities Jagannath, Baladev and Subhadra to me, and I will place them behind my worshipable deity Ganesha. But if I lose the battle, I shall surrender my deity Ganesha to him to be placed behind Jagannath, Baladev and Subhadra.
Purushottama understood he will lose the battle. His camp was also set on fire by the enemies. He was very much afraid and concerned that he would lose his deities. In fright, he fled back to Puri.
What is happening to me in the battle? Why am I being defeated all the time? I am gradually weakening.
Dear King, did you call your beloved deities to help you in the war? Did you at least inform them and take their blessings?
My dear lordships, being engaged in your service of sweeping the road, the King of Kanchi felt insulted and cancelled the marriage proposal. If I am defeated in this battle, is it not your defeat? It is a great insult to you. How can you, the Lord of the Universe, sit behind the deity of Ganesha?
Dear Purushottama, do not be worried. Go ahead and fight with the king of Kanchi and his army. But this time, Balabhadra and myself will help you in the battle.
Sure, my dear lord. You are my only hope and strength.
Oh, it is scorching hot here. Dear brother, I am feeling very thirsty. Can you find something to drink?
I can see a cowherd lady with buttermilk over there. Come, let's quench our thirst with some buttermilk and then continue our journey.
Hey, stop there! You just cannot leave the place like that. Please pay for the whole pot of buttermilk you drank.
Oh, old lady, we are soldiers. We are going to fight a battle. We don't have anything to pay you.
Please don't say that. This is my only livelihood to maintain my family.
Okay. Stop crying, old lady. Let's do one thing.
You keep this ring with you. After some time, our king will pass by this way. You show him this ring and he will pay for the buttermilk.
Stop.
What happened, old lady? Why are you bothering us?
Two of you are young soldiers, one in black riding the white horse and another in white riding the black horse, came to me and drank whole of my buttermilk. When I asked them for money, they gave me this ring and told me to show this to you and ask for money.
This is Lord Jagannath's ring. Oh, fortunate mother, you have personally served Lord Jagannath and Baladev. Thank you so much. Here, take this money.
Oh, how fortunate I am.
See that? Lord Jagannath and Balabhadra reached the kingdom of Kanchi and started fighting. As Purushottama approached the war field, he was astonished to see the two young boys fighting ferociously against the army of Kanchi, as if they were just enough to defeat the entire army. Finally, the great king of Kanchi was defeated. He surrenders to King Purushottama and hands over the deity of Lord Ganesha.
Arrest and bring his daughter to Puri.
After the king victoriously returned to his palace in Puri, he denied marrying the princess due to the great insult he had faced.
Search for the best road sweeper. I shall get this girl married to him.
Please do not worry, my dear innocent princess.
I truly had affection for the king, but now he has ordered you to get me married to a low-class man.
Please depend on Lord Jagannath. He will certainly help you. The minister was puzzled. He thought of a very tricky way to give a fair decision. Days passed by, and soon it was again the time of Rath Yatra the next year. The streets were full, and Lord Jagannath, Balabhadra, and Subhadra were already sitting on their chariots. Thousands of people filled the streets, and the transcendental vibration of Nama Sankirtan along with the Mridanga, conch shells and kartals filled the air. The king of Puri walked with a golden broom in hand, his heart filled with great devotion for Lord Jagannath, swept the roads with great pleasure. My dear king, you told me to bring the best road sweeper as a suitable husband for Princess Padmavati. Today, I have found that person.
Very nice. But I do not have time for this. It is Rath Yatra time now. Do as you wish and get her married to him.
But my dear king, the street sweeper I have chosen is you, your highness.
I appreciate your sneaky intelligence, my dear minister. I accept your proposal.
With this happy ending, it was once again proven that the Lord never fails to take care of His devotees in every walk of their life. We should always remember to keep the Supreme Lord in our thoughts and the rest assured. He shall bestow His mercy upon us.